जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता। पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा। तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा। जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता। जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
What is the classification of the money supply? Money supply is nothing but the total stock of money circulating in an economy is called as the money supply. The circulating money involves the currency, printed notes, money in the deposit accounts and in the form of other liquid assets. Valuation and analysis of the money supply help the economics and policy makers to the frame the policy or to alter the existing policy of increasing or reducing the supply of money. The valuation is important. It is ultimately affect the business cycles and thereby affects the economy. Periodically, every country central bank publishes the money supply. In India, Reserve Bank of India publishes to the money supply data based on the monetary aggregates set by them. In India, Reserve Bank of India follow the M0, M1, M2, M3 and M4 monetary aggregates. I think money supply means total amount of money in an economy, how its circulation. And what is the importance of the supply of money to the Indian economy? At the position of the coronavirus 19 pandemic situation, the effective money supply consists money supply, currency and demand deposits. Currency include all coins and paper money issued by the government and the Reserve Bank of India. Bank deposits are regarded part of money supply and they constitute about the 75% to 80% of the total money supply in USA. Some economics also include near money or such liquid assets as savings, deposits and government bills in the money supply. The total supply of money, very important, the total supply of money is determined by the banks, the Federal Reserves, businessmen, the government and the consumers. But the supply of money, very important for the economic system. How people circulate up the money properly used and further development of the economic activities to the country. For theoretical purpose, money is defined as any assets which performance the functions of money, especially for money means medium of exchange, purchasing of the goods and services to the person to person and place to place. Whereas there are many financial assets with performance these function to greater or lesser degree, and this makes it is a difficult to measure empirical the magnitudes of money. It should be noted that money supply, which refers to the total stock of domestic means of payment owned by the public, that money supply. Money supply, which refers to the total stock of domestic money owned by the public in a country. We consider the stock of money is spendable from only the main source of money supply. In other words, the cash balance held by central and state government with the central bank and its treasuries are generally excluded on the ground that they arise out of the non-commercial particular administrative operation of the government. Thus, the quantity of money means the total amount of money in circulation in the various economic activities of the our country. The total stock of money always refers to the stock of money held by the public through history. The question of not only what constitutes money but where it comes from has been both important and controversial. My dear students, very interesting subject. In contrast to income, which is measured over time, the money is a stock, not a flow. Since money is a stock, it means the amount of money in existence at any point of time must be held by some entity in the economy. Economics make a distinction between amount of money in existence any point of time and the amount that people and institutions may want to be hold for various reasons for the money. When the amount of money actually being held coincide with the amount of money individuals, business houses and governments actually want to hold, a condition of monetary equilibrium exists. So that is why a distinction must be made between the currency deposits, current account of banks which have status of money, and deposit accounts. The reason being, the time deposit of commercial banks can be drawn only at the end of the fixed period, earlier by paying a penalty or by obtaining the prior permission. These are all to the equivalent to the means of payment. There are no doubt liquid assets, by they are not so liquid, you know, as to rank as money. What distinguishes deposits is the fact that they earn an interest income, can be converted into the payment only after some delay and not once. As such, these time savings deposits are excluded from the pool of the money supply. And from almost all, it has therefore it be observed that various measures of money supply keep on changing from country in the country from time to time country. As a such, measurement of money supply becomes as an empirical matter. Up to 1968, the Reserve Bank of India published a single measure of money supply. Now it is called as M and later on M1, defined as currency and demand deposits held by the public. It was called the narrow measure of money supply. After 1968, the Reserve Bank of India started publishing broader measure of money supply called aggregate monetary reserves, defined as M or M1 plus the net time deposits of banks held by the public, whether it is M3. However, since 1977, Reserve Bank of India is publishing data on four alternative measures of money supply denoted by M1, M2, M3 and M4. M1, M2, M3, M4, what it indicates, what it represents. Now M1 equal to C plus DD plus OD. M2 equal to M1 plus saving deposits with post office saving banks. M3 equal to M1 plus net time deposits of banks. M4 equal to M3 plus total deposits with the post office saving banks, where C stands for currency held by public, DD stands for net domestic deposits of banks, and OD implies other deposits of the RBI. Currency include paper currency and coins, that is notes issued by the RBI, and 1 rupee and other small coins issued by the Government of India. Attention, my dear students, the Reserve Bank of India to printed currency, paper currency notes, and also 1 rupee and other small coins issued by the Government of India. Net demand deposits include deposits held by public and not interbank deposits, deposits held by one bank for another. These are not held by public, hence excluded. Other deposits of the RBI are its deposits other than those held by government, banks and a few others. Deposits constitutes very small portion money supply, hence could be ignored. Very interesting that money supply circulating to the economy, money supply from Reserve Bank of India, money supply classified, there are four kinds of the money supply. Money supply from M1 to M4 has its adherence, but by and large most economics prefer the most common sense and most acceptable definition of money or money supply. That is M1, because it includes everything that is generally acceptable as a means of payment. But one more, once you go behind currency and demand deposits, it has hard to find a logical place to stop, since many things, bonds, stocks, debt instruments, contain liquidity in very varying degree. It is better to say that to start to M1 definition of money supply including currency plus all demand deposits. Then we discussed the high powered money and measurement of money. Students, attention to that, it should be noted that money supply is not always policy determined. In fact, money supply is determined jointly by monetary authority, banks and the public. It is true that the role of monetary authority is predominant in determining the supply of money. There are two types of money must be distinguished. One is ordinary money, M, and second one is high-powered money. What is ordinary money? What is high-powered money? Ordinary money we have known as the currency plus demand deposits. The particular formula M is equal to currency plus demand deposits. On the other hand, high powered money is the money produced by the RBI and the government of India, held by the public and the banks. It is also called as high power money. Very important. Students, attention that to ask the 2 marks question. Define high powered money. High powered money produced by the RBI and the government of India, held by the public and banks. Then the RBI calls high reserve money. H is the sum of that currency held by public, cash reserve of the banks, other deposits of RBI. We can ignore item from theoretical discussion, as it hardly constitutes 1% of total H. Hence, H is equal to C plus R. Now, if we compare the two questions, two types of money, ordinary money as well as high-powered money, we define C is a common to both. The difference between the M and H is due to demand deposits in M and R. This difference is of vital importance. Now I think banks are producers of demand deposits, and these demand deposits are treated as money at par with currency. But to be able to create demand deposits, banks have to maintain R, which in turn is a part of high powered money produced only by the monetary authority, not by banks. We know in a practical reserve banking power, high powered money is compared to M, the power of serving as the basic for multiple creation of demand deposits. That is why H is also called as based money. H thus becomes the single most dominant factor of determining money supply. Therefore, H theory of money supply, also called as money multiplier theory of money supply. But the actual measurement of money in the modern economy has become an extremely complex matter. You can see that M1, M2, M3, M4, there are 4 kinds of the Reserve Bank of India money. It is also called as the relationship between to the higher powered money, and central bank money provides a support base for several units. Money, it is in actually circle. The monetary base is important because changes in it have the power to produce multiple change circulating money. The size of monetary base in turn changes or fluctuate with changes in assets and the liabilities of the central bank. So what the central bank has under its control is the size of money. Whether or not changes in the monetary base actually lead changes in money circulation depends upon how the public react to such a change. It is for public to decide whether or not to change its holding currency. Deposits and financial assets that serve as money is response to the change in monetary base. Hence, the link between monetary base and the total money in circulation is real one. Now, the next concept is measures of money supply. Now it is called M0, M1, M2, M3. Thus, total stock of money in circulation among the public at particular point of time is called money supply. The measure of money supply in India are classified into four categories. Already Reserve Bank of India to classify the four categories of the money supply. M1, M2, M3, M4 along with M0. This classification was introduced in April 1977 by Reserve Bank of India, measure of money supply. Let us discuss that. Reserve money, M0 is reserve money. It is also known as high powered money, monetary base, base money, etc. M0, currency in circulation, plus bankers and deposits with Reserve Bank of India, plus other deposits with RBI. It is the monetary base of economy. And then narrow money, M1 is a narrow money. M1 equal to currency with public plus demand deposits with the banking system. In the banking system, current account, saving account and other accounts, plus other deposits with RBI. M2 is equal to, it is clear indicating that M2 is equal to M1 plus saving deposits of post office savings banks. And next one is broad money, M3. You see that broad money, M3 is equal to M1 plus time deposits with the banking system. And then M4 equal to M3 plus all deposits with post office saving banks. Now let us discuss to the first understanding the meaning of money supply or monetary supply. But simply it is that already we have studied that the money supply is the total stock of money that is circulation in an economy on specific day. On specific day, how much money circulates on specific day, what is the importance of the money supply. This is include all the notes, coins, demand deposits held by the public on such a day. Such as money demand, money supply is also a stock variable. One important point to note is that the stock of money kept with the government's central bank. Now there are essential three main sources of money supply in our economy. There are producers of the money and are responsible for its distribution in the economy. The government who produce all the coins and 1 rupee notes. The Reserve Bank of India, which issues all paper currencies. At presently in India, which is the circulation of the money? Your attention that, students, attention that please. The circulation of money, the Reserve Bank of India, which issues all the paper currency. One side, other side, the government which produce all the coins and 1 rupee notes. So therefore, we have concluded that in India, circulation of money, paper currency and coins. Measures of, next one, measures of money supply in India. Monetary economics had a different view regarding the constituents of money supply. Broadly, there are two views. One is traditional views, another one is modern views. Traditional view, according to traditional view, money supply is composed of currency money and legal tender that is coins, currency, notes. In India, the circulation of money is the legal tender money. And second B1, bank money is a checkable demand deposits with the commercial banks. Because bank money is different and the legal money is the different. Legal money is the legal authority by the government of India as well as the Reserve Bank of India. Then bank money, it is a circulation of checkable demand deposits with commercial banks. Yes, very interesting. And next one, modern view. According to the modern view, the phenomenon of money supply refers to the whole spectrum of liquidity in the assets profile of the individual. Thus, in the modern approach, money supply is the wider concept which includes coins, currency notes, demand deposits with banks, time deposits with the banks, financial assets. Such deposits with the non-banking financial intermediaries like the post office saving banks, building societies, and F, treasury and exchange bills, and G, bond and equity. The basic differences between the traditional and modern view is due to their emphasis on the medium of exchange function of money. Money and stock of value of money respectively, while the acceptance of medium of exchange function of money supply